So why the trek? This was a chance with the National Awareness Project to assist people and integrate my interests and do it for a larger purpose, a commitment for Canadians and for people with a disability. My interests have been drama, law, public advocacy, and I like recreation too, and this combined all of them. And I felt that this trek could show the contribution people with a disability can make to Canada. It's also a message for really all Canadians that they can get past their barriers with the right kind of team behind them.
This morning, in probably about a half an hour, I'm going to be driving out to Cape Spear, and from there, start a trek that is going to be approximately 10,000 kilometers. We're in search of dignity, opportunity, and outcome for people with a disability. And it's going to happen with volunteer support and the support of folks like you as we make this trek and show in a very positive way the contribution that people with a disability can make to Canadian society. Whatever your barriers, whatever may be perceived as problems, they get turned around when you have friends, the support of friends, when you have the support of family. And that's the message, whatever we encounter. I'd just like to show you a couple of things. First is a paddle painted by a woman named Dawn Kilgore and her daughter, Heather Kilgore. You'll see a fellow here wheeling, looking out to the ocean on the east coast. There's wheat fields in the middle, there's rocky mountains, and it ends with the ocean at the very end. So it will be dipped into the water here, and it will be dipped into the water on the west coast when the Cross Canada Trek is done.
I'm delighted to be here this morning. Delighted to see you, old man. And you're looking wonderful, and I love that hat. You know, Dave, some years ago, I was invited to give a speech in Victoria. And I opened my speech by saying, when the aeroplane had left St. John's this morning, if it had been going in the other direction, I would have flown all the way across the Atlantic, Ireland, England, France, Switzerland, the Balkan countries, and landed in Istanbul, Turkey, and have gone a less distance than I did in coming to Victoria. So that's what you're setting out to do. And I think it's a marvelous challenge. I have to tell you, by the way, that you're going to Cape Spear. Now, Cape Spear was first named by the French as Cape d'Espoir, and of course, Newfoundlanders couldn't get their tongue around that, and so eventually it became Cape Spear. But it means Cape of Hope. And that's what you're bringing to all the people across Canada, a message of hope. We're a great example. I congratulate you, and I wish you Godspeed.
We were supposed to have motors to make the wheelchair go 14 kilometers an hour. Those never arrived before the start date. That meant the chair was only averaging eight kilometers per hour. That was quite slow. We have a schedule to meet to get to Halifax in 2.5 weeks, and we're just not making it.
Do you think we can do 10 hours a day then? I think that's impossible. Do you have a copy of the itinerary there?
Do what? What?
From 6 in the morning until 7 at night. Yeah. Did you say tomorrow is the day? Or would you? Until 6.
We're seeing freezing rain tapering to freezing drizzle today. Fog patches will continue. Periods of rain, drizzle, and fog. That's tonight, tomorrow. And for Friday, snow or rain on the Avalon, flurries everywhere else. Saturday, Sunday, cloudy with flurries. It's -1 right now at Magic 94.
It's certainly, it's been tough. Quite frankly, it's been really tough. The temperature has been sub-zero every day. There's been ice rain.
So you're warming up?
Yeah.
Don't mess around with me now.
Hey, I'll stop. Well, why don't we stop in half an hour and you can do a check?
And just when all of that nasty weather stopped, then the temperature plummeted. We're moving along and the weather's going to get better. So we're going to make it, even if the weather stayed this bad. We've invested 2 years of our lives into getting ready for this, and we're not turning back.
Yeah, the weather is not cooperating that well, but the scenery is. That's keeping us occupied. It's beautiful out here.
I'm really forcing myself physically to go to new levels, and I know that these days are starting from 5 in the morning and going until midnight for the entire team and myself, and the team's feeling the pressure too, and they're fighting to keep their head above water. It's beyond just something that's about Dave or something personal. It's about assisting people with a disability in Canada. There's 4.5 million Canadians with a disability. You add to that their loved ones, their family members, the people that they've touched in their lives, and you've got virtually every Canadian with a vested interest in this tour. And I'm not going to let those people down, especially the 4.5 million Canadians. But I do believe sincerely that not only can this trek raise awareness, but it can also raise monies to grant monies to go to those people with a disability. So just journey on and think about the goals or the mission. That in a way helps to inspire me or elevate me outside of what may be fatigue, pain, crummy weather, whatever. The support from the people of Newfoundland, all along the way, people honking and encouraging me, and so people are rallying around, and this is just beginning. A midget hockey team, they were on their way home, and they turned their bus around, came back, stopped me on the road, and they pulled a collection. Each guy put money together. That inspires me when out of the sincere human effort, they just jumped out of their bus and helped out the Cross Canada Tour. That's what I truly appreciate. So people are rallying around, and this is just beginning. This is just beginning. I'm only 300 kilometers into Newfoundland, and we've got then 9,500 plus kilometers to go. I really feel good about that. As long as the people keep on nudging me along and encouraging me, it doesn't matter what's slowing me down. I'm going to get to the other side of the coast.